I'm Troy from Studio 33 Guitar. Thanks for watching. And today we're looking at how to play the solo from John Mayer's new song, Last Train Home. I've also made a few other videos about this song. There's another one that talks about just how to play the chords. I'll put a link in the description below for that, as well as another one that talks about how to get the tone and what pedals you need for it, and then also an acoustic version of the song. So I'll put links to all those in the description below. This song's been out for a couple of weeks now, so I've had an opportunity to watch a few videos of him playing it, both live and in the original video and on his TikTok. And so I think the way that I'm going to show you here is the most accurate to how he's actually playing it. The solo is really melodic and it's got some great licks in it. So let's jump right in, zoom in on the neck, and have a look at how to play this solo. As I mentioned, I do have another video that talks specifically about how to get the tone with the pedals and the gear that I'm using. So make sure you watch that video as well if you're interested in replicating John's tone on this solo. But for this video, we're just gonna look at the notes that he's playing. So we're gonna start this solo up here at the 15th fret on the B string, and we're gonna bend that up a whole step, and we're gonna add some vibrato. And then the next phrase sounds like this. So for that, he's bending that same note up again and then coming down and then to the 12th fret, so like this. And then we're doing the same on the next string up. And then landing on the 14th of the D string. The next phrase sounds like this. So that's starting on the 14th fret of the G string. Doing that same kind of trick up and down and then to the 12th. Then we're going back to the 14th. Starting to bend it up. And then we're grabbing the 12th fret on the B string. So when I first heard the song, I thought he was doing this. But you can see when you watch the video, he does come and play this note. So when you bend this note, it ends up being the same note as that, but just kind of adds a little bit of a different flavor when he plays this note instead of playing this twice. Then we do the same thing on the next two strings down, starting on that 15th fret again. So same idea. But that time we're gonna follow it up with a short little bend on the 14th fret. So that's gonna be like this. So those two licks together. Okay, next we're gonna go to the 15th fret on the high E string and we're gonna play a lick like this. Okay, so that's the 15th fret up a whole step, then down to the 12th, then to the 14th on the B string, back to the 12th, and then 14 to 12. The next phrase goes like this. So that's just 12, 14, 12, 12, and then bend up on the 14th. Next we have this kind of cascading pattern, sounds like this. So that's gonna start with 12 to 14 on the high E. To 14 on the B, back to 12 on the high E. So it's like this. Then you have 12 to 14 on the B, and then 13 on G. So far, back to 12 with the index finger on the B. Then you're going to come down to the ninth on the G, and you're going to slide up to the 11th and back to the 9. So together. Now the next phrase I've seen him play a couple of different ways depending on which version you're listening to. One that he does on TikTok sounds like this. And that one starts with the 9th fret on the B string, and you give that a half step bend. Then to the 11th fret on the G, 11th fret on the D, and then back to the 9th fret on the G. Now I've also seen a video of him playing that lick like this. So that's just the 11th fret bending up and down to the 9, and then the 11th on the D and back to the 9 again. So you can decide which way you want to play that. The first one again was like this. The other one was. Okay, the next phrase sounds like this. That's in that same spot, the 11th bend up. And then you're going to slide up to the 13th. And then to the 12th on the B. And then 14 on the B. And you actually play that twice. Now the second time that you do that little lick, you're gonna go like that. And then you're gonna bend the high E string, this note, up a whole step, 2 times. And then just to the regular non-bent note. And that's a tough little bend to do. John does it with his middle finger, but you could do it with your ring finger if you want to use these other 2 fingers in behind to give a little bit more support. You can decide whichever finger you want to use. But that whole riff there together would sound like this. And then he does it again, but first, you're going to go back the index finger and then ring finger. So again, that whole thing sounds like this. Now this next one is a repeating pattern and it sounds like this. So that starts out with the 12th fret on the B string to the 14th fret on the high E, and you're gonna bend that 14th fret up 1 whole step, 2 times. And then down. From there, you're gonna go down to the 12th fret on the E string, and then the 14th fret on the B string. So like this, and then back 12th fret to the 14th. And that's going to repeat similarly on the next string, starting at the 14th fret of the B string. It's going to sound like this. So bending that 14th up, back down to the 12th, to the 13th on the G, back to the 12th, back to the 14th. Then we're going to shift down and do again very similar pattern down here at the 11th fret have your finger on the 11th fret and your index finger on the 9th fret getting ready for it. And that's going to look like this. So 11th bent up, down to 9, 11th on the D string, back to the 9, back to 11. And then the final one is going to be up here at the 9th fret on the A string, and again get your index finger on the 7th to be ready for it. And that's identical to that last one, just on these strings. And then that phrase is ended with this little riff here. Sounds like this. So that one starts in that same position that we were just in. So we've got the 9-7-9 sliding up to 11. And then we're going to shift down to the next set of strings. 9 and 11. And then 9 on the next string, back to 11 on the D. And then it ends with a quick 9 on the D string. So together that sounds like this. And that's the main part of the solo, but then the song starts to fade out and you can still hear a little bit. The next little lick that he plays during the fade out sounds like this. So that is 9 to 11 on the D. And then you're going to skip the string and you're going to jump up and grab this 9 on the B string. And then back to 11 on the D. 9 on the G. Back to 11 on the D. And then at the very end of the fade out, you can hear him slide up to 13 on the G and 12 on the B. He kind of does a little lick similar to that. And then the song fades out, and that's about all you can hear. So I'll play through the entire solo slowly from the beginning. It's going to sound like this. So there you have it, there's the entire solo. And again, if you want to learn more about the tone and how to replicate that sound that John Mayer has, then make sure that you check the link in the description below. I'll go through all the pedals and the settings that I'm using to get this tone. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.